I am Krishna ma'am, your science teacher. I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. When you are at your home, we are going to take care of your studies through these educational videos. So go through this video and clear your doubts. So students, today we are going to discuss about the topic eating habits of animals. This is your chapter 3. So let's start. So students, when we look around our surrounding, we can see many animals, many type of plants. They used to work, they used to move from one place to another place. So from where they get this energy to work, to move, to do every work? They need food for this energy. So animals need food for the energy to do work, to move. For their growth also, they need food. To stay healthy, they need food. Each animal, every animal have different food habits. You can see whatever the cow is eating, the cat or dog will eat the same things. No, they are different from each other. So let's see what is the difference between their eating habits. So according to their eating habits, the animals are classified as herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. And one more is there, that is scavengers. So students, animals animals. example of hugging boots, cow, horse, sea, giraffe, and friend. Indian name. So these are the hugging boots. Now the second one is your carnivore boots. These also consist of two words. That's it. Carnivore. Carni means flesh of animals, and vora it is eating, to eat. So the animals which eat the flesh of other animals are known as carnivores. They are also called as flesh eating animals. Therefore, the flesh-eating animals. These carnivorous animals, they get their energy by consuming the other animals' flesh. They get their nutrients, everything they need to survive in this earth, they get from this animals, other animals. The example of carnivores are tiger, lion, moose, cheetah, etc., etc. Okay, these are the carnivores animals. They are called flesh eating animals. Now the third is omnivores. Omni word came from Latin word there. That means both. Both means plant as well as the flesh of animals. So these animals, which animals used to eat both the part of plant also and flesh of other animals also, they are called as omnivores. For example, crow, dog, these animals used to eat both type of food. The foods cooked by the human beings, we used to give these animals, they used to eat that. Dog also eat the meat, mutton, they also like bones of this mutton. Okay, now the third is your scavenging food. Scavengers, the animals which eat the flesh of dead animals. They used to eat the flesh of dead animals. They are very important for the environment. By eating these dead animals' flesh, they used to clean up our environment. So the example of scavengers are hyena, then vulture, etc. These are the examples of scavengers. So according to food habits, what are the types of animals? Herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, and scavengers. They are also called plant-eating animals. This one is flesh-eating animal. this one is both it in. Both it in. Both it in and they are dead. They are the dead animals. Flesh. Yes, Peter. These are the four types of animals. Now, the second topic is your food chain. Now, what is this food chain? You can see that these herbivores, what they used to eat? They eat parts of plants. So from where they are getting their food? From plants. Now this carnivore is getting their food from where? From herbivore. Now these carnivores used to eat the flesh of herbivores. Omnivores, they can eat the both type of food, scavenger and dead animals. So directly or indirectly, these animals are depend on each other. For example, A deer used to eat what? Grass. Now this deer is eaten by tiger. This type of food chain is going on in our surroundings. The process of eating and being eaten is called the food chain. Food chain. The eating of food and being eaten by other animals is called the food chain. Grass. If suppose that grass is not there, so deer cannot eat, they don't have food, then they cannot survive. If deer is not there, then tiger can survive. Tiger will not get their food, so they can't survive. So tiger depend on the way by the help of which this food chain going on in our surrounding. So food chain, what is food chain? The eating and being eaten is called the food chain. I hope you have understood this topic. The types of animals according to their food habits and the food chain of animals. Now one question is there in page number 23. You can do this. 23 page number. And in exercise also you can do page number 27. Okay. In next class we will learn about the animals, how they eat, what are the features present in them by the help of which they can eat that foods. Okay student, I hope you have understood these two topics. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.